Good evening and welcome to the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. My name is Rupert Everett and I've been entrusted with the sacred responsibility of hosting this sultry Super Bowl of underwear. Why me? I suppose with all the models changing in and out of their knickers, I seemed like a safer bet than Charlie Sheen, I don't know. Well, here we are at Bryant Park, we're in New York City, security is tight and so are the girls. Over 1,000 police officers are outside trying to get in. It's pure mayhem. Now, on an evening like tonight, credentials are everything. You are nobody without A, the backstage pass, B, the after-party pass, and of course, C, the access all areas pass. And then we've got here the key to Heidi Klum's trailer. Tonight, we have 25 of the most beautiful models in the world and performances by Mary J. Blige and Andrea Bocelli. Now, let's start by taking a look at how Victoria's Secret has become part of the very fabric of our culture, while using very little fabric.
Our mission is about to begin. So please, fasten your seatbelts and prepare for takeoff.
The Victoria's Secret Angels are back.
You were the Victoria's Secret model who wore that, what was it, a $10 million bra? You don't have it on now, do you? Okay, all right, here we go.
Have you seen my Victoria's Secret catalog?
Yeah, it's in the bathroom with Junior.
Hey, Charlie, you want to go with me to the Victoria's Secret?
Yes.
Glad to see that you got your cardio workout in.
Hey, at least I got the mail.
You got it. Looking for something in particular? Tyra, can I ask you a question? Is it still called underwear, even though you're not wearing it under anything?
Yeah, it is.
Just a question.
You're all Victoria's Secret supermodels.
What are you doing in our dressing room?
I gotta be honest, I didn't expect to see so many negligees. I mean, there were a few secrets Victoria should have kept to herself, am I right?
That's Rhea Durham. She's a Victoria's Secret cover girl. She's a smoking hot supermodel.
I don't see it.
It's only minutes away until the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show begins. On behalf of every tongue-twisted guy who has ever tried to strike up a conversation with a delicious crumpet, I will introduce to you the caring, multi-talented personalities beneath the bras. Come with me.
Do other fashion shows, so for me this is like really exciting. Like I have a great time and I go down the runway and I'm laughing because I'm having a great time. I'm like an angel in wings and I'm like, woohoo, here I come.
I like to make fun of myself.
And you have to say no. Well, you know, I'm Carolina Zoolander. You know, I like to have fun and enjoy and smile. And my new name, Carolina's Wonder.
It's really exciting, this show, because it's kind of like the hot thing, the hot ticket to go to. Everybody in town wants to go. You know, it has a certain kind of edge to it, because in all reality, we are all in our underwear. So there's that energy, but there's also a little bit of nervous tension.
I like the fact that they've got a little bit more of an edge with the girls they're using, but it's not necessarily so perfect. I'm always sort of labeled as sort of the weird looking model, and all of a sudden I'm doing a Victoria's Secret show. It's quite hilarious in a way, you know, but I'm like, yeah, that's brilliant.
Like I always tell people, sometimes you make your own luck. Always be nice to people. Like I always tell that to younger girls, be nice to the assistants. Be nice to the assistants of the assistants, because those assistants will be your next cameraman or your next director, because we're not God's gift to this earth.
I love photography. I've been taking pictures forever, and I know how to make the people in front of the camera comfortable, and it's about catching the right moment. I don't want them to pose, so it's very enthusiastic. I just want to catch the reality.
I am so nervous about this show. And my friend was like, oh my God, you are going to do that show? And I was like, no, don't tell me. Oh God, I am truly. I'm nervous. I'm just holding it down. I'm like sweating right now. Oh God.
I mean, imagine you don't know and you're standing there in your little underwear, your bra, and you're like putting your breast good in front of that mirror, and it's like on television.
We are in the center of the honeycomb where I'm reaping the benefits of my backstage pass. Let me make some introductions. This is Maggie, or as I like to call her, Princess Rubylicious. And this is Molly. By the way, Molly, that blusher is fantastic. You've got to give me the name of it before the end of the evening, okay?
Hey,
darling, how are you?
I'm good.
Oh, that was some evening in Milano the other night. Oh, anyway, you've got a little pre-recorded thing you need to watch now, so we'll see you later. So anyway, then I said to Donatella, if Kate is going to do that, I'm not coming. I mean, really, is that outrageous?
I guess I'm a little bit nervous because I'm sure that all these girls have been working out for like a month before this show, and I have no time because all I do is work. And my workout is to go from one plane to the next, so I don't know what am I going to look like because I haven't put a bikini in a long time. I think, you know, I can manage, so I don't know. Hopefully after you tell me, okay, if I was bad. Because I have no idea. I wish I had time to preparations. Like, everyone is saying, like, preparation. I'm like, which preparation, girl? What are you talking about? There's no time for preparation.
I love doing fashion shows. You have 15 minutes to show everything, and you have to be an actor, actually, you know, an actress. It's like an acting part of the fashion business, I think, because it's so crazy, but you have to show everything is beautiful.
On every level, no matter where, women are insecure, and I want to be like, you don't have to be insecure. You know, take what makes you feel good and have fun. I hope that through my movies I can make women want to like say, doll, you know, and then they become incredibly beautiful.
Most of us models never do lingerie shows. So it's a bit, you know, it's a bit different. It's like a time to be sexy. Like, you don't have to, you know, you're not wearing a suit or this or that. And obviously you have to really make yourself feel like you look sexy because you don't really have much to hide.
There's a lot of chaos backstage. I guess you get used to it. I think that's sort of what adds to the show energy. You've got people pulling you here and doing your hair and touching up your makeup. It's sort of nice that, you know, when you get on the catwalk, it's sort of your time and you're by yourself and no one's pulling at you, and you know that's your time to sort of relax and do your thing.
Everyone's watching you. Like, there's so many people watching you. And it's not just watching you in clothes. They're watching you in your G-string, in your bra. And you're just, like, trying to walk straight and be sexy, but relax. But it's just, it's really scary. I'm pretty freaked out. We'll see what happens.
After that last night with you in Paris, I just cannot get you out of my mind.
Baby, it's the same thing for me too. That night was electrifying. But Tyra, God chose different paths for you and me. I took the road less traveled.
No, baby, Rupert, people change.
It works every time.
I like rock and roll, punk girl. I need music to be so loud in my ears that when I come out of this place, I'm like, you know? I'm making a band now for some models friends. It's gonna be psycho. It's gonna be so crazy. It's just gonna be crazy. It's gonna be inspiring and crazy.
It's first time that I work for Victoria's Secret, and I love the outfits. I think it's their most sexy ever. And I think this is in a way different because it's much more being a woman, you know, much more being show, you know, yourself. I'm really comfortable to be in underwear. I really like to do that, and actually I'm doing all the time. My jobs is all with bathing suit or with underwear, or like, you know, I'm not scared to show my body.
You always have to remember when you start modeling that you have a family. Doesn't matter if 200 people tell you that you're horrible, you don't fit the clothes, and you always have to remember that you have someone in your back that loves you, that protects you, and you're better than that.
You see a lot of different things being a model. You get in contact with a lot of different kind of extreme characters, and it's very interesting. Narrow-minded people, that's like something that can make me angry. I think people have to be open-minded.
Because of the Victoria's Secret, the runway, I think, is amazing because they always do like different things. We get the chance to be more expressive and more sexier. Which I love, and I think this year will be amazing.
The fact that fashion is so international, it's the one of the best parts of it. I mean, even in this one show, you know, you see such a mix of people. Some girls come from Europe, some come from Africa, America, they're from all over the world. That's a great thing about the fashion business.
Get off me! Stay tuned, and soon you'll get to see Heidi Klum in a $12 million bra. And the amazing thing is, you might not even notice the bra.
Getting ready to do the Victoria's Secret fashion show, and we're just ready to start and walk in the runway. Oh my God, I can't wait.
Is the moment to accidentally lock your wives or girlfriends in the attic, because we are going to take a virtual tour of Heidi Klum's body. Are you ready, Heidi? You guys, I'm standing here with Heidi's legs, and let me tell you, they smell delicious. They are as smooth as alabaster, and actually, for example, if I rub my cheek up and down her leg, it's like, oh God, it's like the meeting between a pashmina and a chartouche. And as I kiss my way up her legs, I'm not thinking. What am I thinking? Hair. Don't worry, Heidi, I've got my tweezers in my makeup bag.
Never do I get nervous. Even when I did my first fashion show, they told me to act like a cat, like very cat-like. And I took it literal, and I started like licking my hands, like paws at the end of the runway, and started going meow. And my mom and dad were like, Ty, you really need to study this because that was really awful. But I was never nervous.
I love nature. I've always played sports and been outside. When I have time off, I love to go horseback riding, or I would like to spend time at home with my family, and I go water skiing or biking and just like hanging out in the country. I think you have to take life for what it is, take what you can when you can get it, and be happy with what you get.
I think it's more glamorous, you know, like I think it's the most glamorous shows. Like from all the shows, the season shows, the fashion, this one is like the one that, you know, it's the one. It's just this one, and there's no one that you can compare with Victoria's Secret show.
The best part is walking down the catwalk, you know, that's the easiest part and the most funnest part of it all. It's an adrenaline rush sometimes, you know, especially for this, you know, wearing lingerie and being an angel.
In other kinds of runway shows, you have lots of clothes. Sometimes too many clothes. In this kind of show, you have very little clothes, sometimes almost nothing. I'm hoping that since I had a baby, they'll say, well, you know, we'll postpone the registering for the next year.
We're going to be laughing backstage, like looking out. Oh, your butt is slamming down. It's going to be really funny because, you know, we're going to be looking at every inch of skin of every girl. Because, you know, like, we're girls and we look at everything. And I think it's going to be lots of fun. The music better be good, otherwise it's going to be... it's going to be hard to walk.
We're talking Portuguese.
You know, there is a reason why Victoria's Secret asked me to host this fashion show. You see, it's amazing what I can get away with since, well, yeah, I'm considered one of the girls. You know, I can grab as much flesh as I want and nobody cares. Watch this. Whoa! Oh! Oh! Maybe I'm wrong. I think now would be a good time to take a look at how tonight's Victoria's Secret fashion show came together.
This year's show is the most significant one we've ever done. I mean, it's going to kick off Christmas in New York City, and I think that's a particularly big deal this year. There's an enormous amount of complexity in doing a show like this, an awful lot of creative collaboration with film directors and fashion show directors and producers, the people that have to build the venue, the tent coming in from England.
The idea for the show is that it takes place in this gigantic space, which is built in a translucent manner where the stage and the runway will evolve and change color and change actually materials throughout the show. The way I proceeded, I sketched kind of two dimensions very roughly, then from my sketches I put dimensions and get them done into renderings and animations, as you can see, and then obviously, you know, look at them all together with everybody else concerned, and it's like a puzzle. I mean, it got built over a year.
There's thousands and thousands and thousands of models. And of that group, there's probably a max of like 100 whoever came into consideration for this show.
We looked at thousands of girls, literally. I mean, everyone wanted to do the show.
There's going to be a 90 carat in there.
And it's one of the hardest castings for a model to go on, because she comes in, you ask her to put on a bra and panty and a pair of high heels and parade yourself in front of someone you've never met before.
I'm shy now!
When you think of it, this girl has to walk down and back up 100 feet 3 times, and it sounds like nothing, but it's a lot.
We have no idea what a big deal the wings are to these girls. It's like, I want to be an angel, I want to be an angel. We have different materials this year. We're doing some metal, we're doing one actually with little twinkly lights, and the wings are, you know, they're amazing.
Three girls are going to fly, not the models, but three girls are flying who know how to do that.
I tried to design it in a manner, specifically this time, that would be the most TV-genic that it's ever been.
We knew that we wanted something beyond last year and beyond the internet.
It's an exciting and enticing idea. This is the Super Bowl for supermodels, so that when they get to this stage, they've made it.
I know I've been a perfectly horrible beast, but trust me, all will be forgiven when the world's most alluring beauties hit the runway for the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show Spectacular. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
One more time. One more time, celebrate and dance so free. One more time, I've got me feeling so free. We're gonna celebrate, celebrate.
It doesn't get better than this. The Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. Please welcome the great Andrea Bocelli.
Quel segreto che tenevi con te, una donna, un amore. Quante lettere scritte per lei, per non morire. una voce, due occhi grandi nascosti nel cuore. Sotto un limpido cielo toscano, tanta voglia di sognare. Storie, passione, dolore, ma Scagni vive tra di noi. La luna sparisce dietro alle nubi e un uomo canta dalla blu. Negli occhi l'equatore, grande sogno dei marinai. E la scogliera già svanita, si alzano le vele della vita. E adesso corri verso il mare. Sentirai cantare questa musica dolce che non morirà mai. Ancora la tua forza, il mare libero senza catene. La tua forza, il mare.
Thank you.
Turn. Mary J. Blige performs the number one song in America, and the loveliest women on earth in the most alluring outfits return to the runway on the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. Kicking off the second half of the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show with the number one song in America, Mary J. Blige.
How y'all feel tonight? Yeah, it's a family affair tonight. Come on, come on, come on, let's get it, come on.
Let's get it from the phone, have fun, phone up in this dancery. We got y'all open, now you're floating, so yeah, that's the best for me. Don't need no hateration, holleration in this dancery. Let's get it percolating while you're waiting, so just for me.
Come on, everybody, get on up, 'cause you know we got to get it from Mary J's in the spot tonight, and I'ma make it feel alright. Come on, baby, just party with me. That juice will set your body free. Leave your situations at the door. When you step inside, jump on the floor.
Let's get it from the floor.
Let's get it from the
floor. We got your
lose your mind. Pop you a drink, go ahead and frost your eyes, 'cause we're celebrating so much drama
in our lives. With the Dre track pumping, everybody's jumping. Go ahead and twist your back and get your body bumping.
I told you, leave your situations at the door, so grab somebody and get your ass on the dance floor.
Let's get it
from the
phone, phone up in this dance floor. We got your
love. to be open. Join hands, pray, and have no fear. Go forward, go forward.
Hallelujah.
I hope you're happy with my performance tonight. God knows I've done my best. I remain your loyal and most obedient servant, and on behalf of Victoria's Secret and all their gorgeous angels, I now bid you adieu. Good night.
Vamos.